गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ भद्रं कर्णेभिः शृणुयाम देवाः भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागंसस्तनूभिः व्यशेम देवहितं यदायुः। स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, वी आर् इन् दिस् प्रश्नोपनिषत् फोर्त् प्रश्न एण्ड् वी कम्प्लीटेड् द एय्त् मन्त्र इन् दि लास्ट् क्लास्। दट् ईस् आल् दि सेन्स् आर्गन्स् withdrawing into the Parama Atma. So that is what we have seen. Sayatha Somya Vayamsi Vaso Vruksham Sampratishthate, that was an example given earlier. Just as all the birds, they return to the tree where they dwell. So likewise, all these things, that is all the upadhis, they get absorbed in the Paramatma in the Sushupti state. We have seen that this Prashnopanishad, it has examined in the first three prashnas, it has examined the prana, the entire aspect, all aspects of prana it has examined. And then ultimately it said that prana, it is very, very important, no doubt, but it is not the supreme, that is not the Atman. The fourth question comes to the main question, that is what is Atman, what is this consciousness, and then this supreme consciousness, how to know that supreme consciousness, how to know that as a Swayam Jyoti. So in order to know those things, the Upanishad Rishi, their strategy is to examine the whole human experience, the entire human experience in this Avasthatraya. Avasthatraya is the three states, that is the waking, dream and deep sleep. In all these three stages, what is the experience of a human being? And the strategy of Advaita, we have also seen that in addition to Shruti and Yukti, it also takes into account Anubhava. Anubhava is the actual experience of a human being. So from this, we have seen, from the waking state, we cannot infer much, we did not learn much. In the waking state, okay, we have to do sadhana, we have to do all this deliberation, we have to go to the teacher, learn, and all this is in the waking state. Waking state cannot be dismissed because that is the state in which we do all this speculation, all this, discussion, etc. It takes place only during the waking state. In the dream, what was it we saw in the dream? In the dream analysis, we saw that Atma is a Swayam Jyoti. That is what was seen in the Atma, in that dream state. And then now we are coming to the Sushupti. Sushupti is again being discussed in order to show that Atma is Asanga. We will see in the next mantra, Atma is totally Asanga. It is pure consciousness. It is pure consciousness, is not Karta, Bhokta or anything. When this pure consciousness is associated with all these upadhis, upadhi is the mind, the senses, etc. They are all these upadhis. Not only the human mind, but the mind of an ant, mind of a mosquito, all these things. All these are upadhis. What all is seen, sahasra shirusha purushaha. Not only human heads, but also animal heads, ant head, etc., etc. So all this is purusha, isn't it? So this pure consciousness, when it is reflected in the antahkarana of these, all these upadhis, then it becomes the drashta, srota, experiencer, etc., 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 it becomes. So that is what we will see in the analysis of Sushupti. Sushupti, it is being discussed in order to examine what is the nature of Atma. The nature of Atma is Asanga. The nature of Atma is bliss. Because in that Sushupti, that bliss is being experienced. So that is what we will see in this ninth mantra. In the last class, we completed the eighth mantra, which only talked about Vakcha Vaktavyancha, all these things, Buddhischa Bodhavyancha, Ahankarascha Ahankartavyancha, all these things. What happened? Pranascha Vidharayitavyancha, it has to be connected to the earlier mantra, the last line, Pare Atmani Sampratishtate. All this, it gets merged. are absorbed or resolved into that para atma, that supreme atma. Now we have to see the ninth mantra, and then it is referring to that same para atma. Yesha hi drashta, it starts. Yesha means this. What is this? This. It is referring to that pare atmani sampratishthate. It is referring to that. Let us read the mantra. Yesha hi drashta, sprashta shrota grata rasayita, मन्ता बोद्धा कर्ता विज्ञानात्मा पुरुषः स परेक्षर आत्मनि संप्रतिष्ठते. ओके, सो हियर एष हि द्रष्टा. एष, एष इज दिस पर्सन. हू इज दिस? दिस. इट इज रेफरिंग टू दैट अर्लियर मंत्र परे आत्मनि संप्रतिष्ठते, दट पर आत्म, दट सुप्रीम आत्म, दट सुप्रीम कॉन्शियसनेस. That supreme consciousness, that is the drashta. How is the supreme consciousness drashta? Supreme consciousness by itself, just now I said, by itself it is not having any relation with anything. Only when it is associated with these upadhis, it becomes rather active, it becomes functional, it becomes relational, it becomes drashta, shrota, manta, etc., etc. So that is what is being shown here. Otherwise it is pure druk. That is pure samanya, what is called samanya jnanam. We have come across these two words called samanya jnanam and vishesha jnanam. Samanya jnanam is pure consciousness where there is no triputi, that is knower, known, and this jnata, jnayam and jnanam. That triputi is not there, that means of knowledge, all the three are not there. Whereas vishesha jnanam is where there is a drashta, where in the sense of duality. When you talk about Vishesha Jnanam, you have come to the level of duality. You have come to the level where there is a seer, there is something which is seen, and what is called the Jnanam, the process of knowing. So that is what we have seen. So this Druk or Samanya Jnanam is being called Drashta, Srota, etc. in this mantra. Yesha hi Drashta, this in fact, that is the Drashta. And also Sprashta. Sprashta means the person who sprushidhatu, sprushati. Sprushati means touches. Sprashta means the one who touches. Then shrota, the one who hears. Grata, the one who smells. Rasayita, the one who tastes. Manta, the one who thinks. Manta is actually the manana is actually manadha, manas is at the level of say sankalpa vikalpatmaka manaha, isn't it? It is a recording instrument where it records a sensation and then it speculates, it tries to ascertain what it is. So that is that manta. Bodha, buddhi. Buddhi is nishchayatmika buddhi, where you understand and then decide that aspect. Then karta, the doer. The vijnanatma purushaha. The vijnanatma is the karta. The whole, the notion of I is there in that vijnanamaya kosha. I do this, I am that, I am that. So that vijnanatma is nothing but jiva. Associated with this antahkarana, associated and also almost identified, and also identified with this antahkarana. And when this identification goes, because of vidya, that when avidya is negated, and when that vidya dawns on him, then that vijnanatma realizes that he is not different from that supreme atman. That vijnanatma, the self, disappears, that notion of I disappears, and he realizes, or rather he remains as Brahma. He remains as Brahma. So that is what we will see. So Bodha Vijnanatma Purushaha Sa Pareyakshare Atmani Sampratishtate. At the time of deep sleep, Saha is that this Vijnanatma or Jivatma. Pareyakshare, in that supreme imperishable Brahman, Akshara Brahma. Akshara is one word which we have seen in Mundaka Upanishad also. Na Ksharati iti Aksharam, isn't it? That is that which is imperishable. In that Atman, Sampratishtate. Sampratishtate means it rests, it abides, it resolves, it merges. You can use anything. So, sampratishthate. Then we will see the bhashyam. Atahparam yad atmarupam.
Atahparam yad atmarupam.
Jalasuryakadivad bhoktrutva kartrutvena iha anupravishtam.
Jagatkartru jalasuryakadivad bhoktrutva kartrutvena iha anupravishtam.
Okay. So, this is actually the avatarika for this mantra. Atah param, hereafter. So that means, hereafter means, hereafter we are going to say Atma Rupam means, till now what has been told is not exactly Atma, but is something which is really important and good. So Atah param yad Atma Rupam, that which is Atma Rupam, and what is the nature of this Atma Rupam? Jalasuryakadivat. Just as the reflection of sun is seen in some water body. Reflection of sun seen in a water body, that is jala suryaka. Reflection of sun or the image of sun seen in a water body, jala suryaka adivat. And then this is seen as the doer, this is seen as the karta, this is seen as the enjoyer. Bhokta, bhokta is enjoyer, karta is the doer. So bhoktrutva kartrutvena iha anupravishtam. Anupravishta does not mean that it has really entered. This anupravesha shruti or the shruti which talks about tat srushtvata deva anupravishat etc. There we have seen that this meaning of actually this entering means, what does it mean? It means that this is the place where, this is the upalabdhi sthanam. This is the place where you can identify, this is the place where you can know Brahman. So that is why it is called anupravesha. Like electricity has anupravishta into the bulb. Electricity is always there. It is anupravishta into bulb means, it is the place, upalabdhisthanam is this bulb. That is the place where you can know the, where you can know or ascertain the presence of that electricity is this bulb. So that is upalabdhisthanam. So anupravishtam, that anupravesha, the meaning for that anupravesha is upalabdhisthanam. Then yeshahi drashta sprashta. Let us read. Shrota ghrata rasaita. Manta bodha karta vijnanatma. We just discussed the meaning of these words. For this vijnanatma, so we have to see the meaning. What is the meaning of this vijnanatma? So at that place, because this Sanskrit, this sentence in Sanskrit, we don't have these punctuation marks. So the problem is, unless there are punctuation marks, we get confused. So at this place, vijnanatma, you either put a comma or a full stop. So vijnanatma, you can put a comma or full stop also. So what is the meaning of vijnanatma? He is giving the meaning. For that vijnanatma, we should know what is vijnanam. The one whose nature is vijnanam is vijnanatma, isn't it? Vijnanatma is vijnanam swabhavaha yasya sa vijnanatma, isn't it? Vijnanam swabhavaha yasya saha vijnanatma. That is one whose nature is vijnanam. What is vijnanam? So that is where we are. So vijnanam vijnayate aneneti karanabhutam buddhyadi. Buddhyadi, buddhyadi. There you can put a comma. Idam tu vijanati iti vijnanam. Kartrukaraka rupam. You can put another comma there. So without this, this sentence is confusing, you see. So first derivation is, it is called karana vyutpatti. So for example, a word, suppose you take a word called vijnanam. Vijnayate anena iti vijnanam. Suppose I take my, referring to my eye. I call my eye vijnanam in the sense of karana vyutpatti. That is in the sense of instrumental sense. Karanam is instrument, isn't it? Kartrukaraka, karanakaraka, karmakaraka, you recall those karakas from your grammar, knowledge of grammar. So kartruka, there are so the karakas, kartrukarakam, karanakarakam, sampradanakarakam, apadanakarakam, etc. Karakas are there, isn't it? Adhikaranakarakam, etc. So this is karanakarakam is instrumental sense. So jnayate anena iti vijnanam. That is that by which something is known. Is vijnanam. So I am referring to my eye as vijnanam in karana vyutpatti, in instrumental sense. Is it clear? Vijnanam, suppose I call my eye or my nose as vijnanam, karana vyutpatti, jnayate anena iti vijnanam. By this something else is known. So that is what is vijnanam, that is karana vyutpatti. Here it is written, vijnayate anena iti. Karanabhutam buddhyadi. Karanabhutam, that which is of the nature of karana, that which is actually an instrument. What are they? Buddhyadi, buddhi, etc. These are all the instruments. Buddhi, manas, and all these sense organs, these are all the instruments. Then idam tu, here it is different. Here we should not take the karana vyutpatti, but we have to take kartru vyutpatti. That is in the nominative sense. Kartru vyutpatti in the nominative sense. Janati iti jnanam. Jnanam, for the word jnanam, janati iti jnanam. That is, of course, the V is only an upasarga. Idam tu, vijanati iti vijnanam, kartrukaraka rupam. Here it is not karanakaraka, we have to use take the kartrukarakam. Kartrukarakam is That is, this is what is the seer. This is what is the seer. So, Vijnanatma is nothing but seer. That's all. In simple sense, Vijnanatma is that which knows, that which sees. Vijanati iti Vijnanam. So, Vijnanam Atma yasya saha Vijnanatma. So, in that sense, Vijnanam, for the word Vijnanam, he is taking the Kartrukaraka meaning and not Karanakaraka. That is in the nominative case and not in the instrumental case. Is this clear?
Yes.
Small grammar where we can get lost. Tadatma tatsvabhavaha vijnyatru svabhava ityarthaha. So tadatma, atma means that is the self, that is its nature, that is its very essence. Vijnanam is its very essence, that is knowing, is its very essence. Knowing arises only when in the sense of duality. So is this consciousness which is totally, by its nature it is asanga, it is totally unrelational. Even then, because of the association with these upadhis, it has become a knower, it has become the seer, it has become the drashtas, prashta, etc. Tadatma tat svabhavaha vijnyatru svabhavaha, that is, it is of the nature of knowing things. That is, from a height it has fallen, from the height of being totally asanga, it is now become somebody who is having sangha, it is associated with buddhi, antahkarana, etc. And then it is seen as the Vijnanatma, the knower of things. Ityarthaha. Then it is also called Purusha. That Purusha word is being explained. Purushaha Karyakarana Sanghatoktopadhi Purnatvat Purushaha. Karyakarana Sanghatoktopadhi
Purnatvat Purushaha.
Okay. Purushaha. The meaning is Puri Shete Iti Purushaha, isn't it? Puri. In this body mind complex, it dwells, it pervades. That is what is Purushaha. Purnatvat Purushaha, that which totally fills the body-mind complex, that is, that fully pervades, almost the same meaning, Purushete and Purnatvat both are almost same. Purnatvat, that which is completely filling it, filling the body-mind complex, that is Purusha. And that body-mind complex is being, it is mentioned here, Karyakarana Sanghata Ukta Upadhi, that is Ukta Upadhi. The upadhi which has been mentioned earlier, ukta upadhi, karyakarana sanghata namna uktaha upadhi, ukta upadhi, karyakarana sanghata namna uktaha upadhi, upadhi is strilinga, upadhi, ukta upadhi. So karyakarana sanghata, that is this karyakarana sanghata is the upadhi. This upadhi which is named, this named as karyakarana sanghata, this body mind complex. So, upadhi purnatvat, in that upadhi it is totally filled. In that upadhi it is so totally pervading, it is so totally filled. So, that is why it is called Purusha. Then, sacha, jalasuryakadi pratibimbasya suryadi praveshavat, jaladhyadhara shoshe. What does your book say here? Jaladhyadhara. Dva, that is print mistake. There is no other extra word, isn't it? Jaladhyadhara shoshe.
Jaladhyadhara shoshe.
Pareakshare atmani sampratishthate. See, here we have seen the sun's reflection is there in water bodies. You can have 100 water bodies, 1000 water bodies. There are so many reflections. You take some plate or some plate and then put some water in that. You get some image. Suppose after some time the water dries out, that image is no longer there. Where has the water gone? Image gone. The image, it has, in a way of speaking, you can say that image was never there, or the image has gone back into the sun. So both ways it doesn't matter. You can either say the image has gone back into the sun, or the image was never there. If you say the image was never there, you are coming to the level of Ajatavada. That is, the world, the Srushti itself is not there. The Srushti itself is not there. It is just appearing. So, it is just merely appearing. It is simply not there. Or, if you say that Pareyatmani Sampratishtate, in the case of a Jnani, in the case of a Jnani, he sees the whole thing as something which is non-existing. The Jnani actually, he sees something as totally non-existing. At an empirical level, okay, there is a Vyavahara. At an ordinary level, there is a vyavahara, loka vyavahara, there is some transaction in the world. But at the absolute level, this is in Paratma. So that is what is the meaning here. Sacha, sa is that particular jiva, that vijnanatma, is referring to that vijnanatma. So that vijnanatma, jala suryakadi pratibimbasya suryadi praveshavat. So this jala surya pratibimbam, what has happened to that jala surya pratibimbam when water dried up? Jala dhyadhara shoshe, jala dhyadhara shoshe, jala is the adhara. This jalam or upadhi, jalam is water, that water is the upadhi. For this, what is this, for this, what is this, bimbam, sorry, pratibimbam. So here, jalam is referring to this manas. Jala surya is that chidabhasa. Chidabhasa it is, which is being reflected, which is this, what we call this so-called jivatma. So this one, praveshe, jala dhyadhara shoshe, what happens to this pratibimba? Suryadi praveshavat. It enters back. It enters back into Surya. Yatha jala suryakadi pratibimbaha pratibimbam surye pravishate pravishati. So just like this pratibimba, this image resolves back into the sun. Similarly, this pareyakshare atmani sampratishtate. In the time of Sushupti, it resolves back into the Paraatma, into the Paraatma. Here of course, this Anandagiri gives a small explanation. He gives an explanation that we cannot talk about the laya for Jivatma, because Jivatma also is consciousness. For consciousness there cannot be laya. Only something which is born, it will have laya. Something which is unborn, there is no question of laya. It only says that you can only say that all these upadhis, they get merged. This laya is only for upadhis. And it is only in a figurative sense that it is being sampratishtate, etc. We are now referring to Jivatma as though he is resolving into Paramatma. In a sense, it is okay. But then strictly speaking, it is not the Jivatma as such which is getting resolved into this Paramatma. It is the upadhis which are getting resolved into Paramatma. That is what he writes. Drashtuhu Atmanaha Prithivyadivat Swarupena Akshare Layaha Nasambhavati. Swarupena, drashtuhu atmanaha, this atma is drashta. Prithivyadi swarupena akshare layahana sambhavati. Like this prithivi, etc., in this akshara brahma, this laya cannot happen because it is drashta. Drashta cannot become drushyam. Then sambhavati iti ashankya. So thinking of that, expecting that, anticipating that particular question. Upadhi layaha upahita swarupa bhava eva. Asya layaha ityaha. That is upahita swarupa, upahita rupa bhavaha eva. Upahita rupam is this body mind complex, jivatma, that is the upahita rupam. Upahita means that which is in the upadhi is upahita. That which is in the upadhi is upahita. Upahita rupam is that jivatma, that is which is associated with this body mind complex, which is identifying itself with the body mind complex. So iti upadhi layaha upahita rupa bhavaha eva asya layaha. That is, only this upadhis are getting resolved and not the jivatma. We should not say that the jivatma is getting merged into paramatma, because jivatma has always been paramatma. Only this, once the upadhis have merged, jivatma remains as paramatma. So that is what we can say. So that is what is the explanation by Anandagiri. Pareyatmani sampratishtate. Is it clear? Only the upadhis are getting merged. But in a way of speaking, sa pare atmani acchari sampratishtate, it is being explained. Then the next mantra, tad ekatva vidah phalamaha. So he is referring to one more point. Tad ekatva vidah phalam. Ekatva vidah means ekatva vit. Means what is ekatva vit? Ekatva vit is one who knows the oneness. Ekatvam is oneness. Ekatva vit is one who knows the oneness. Ekatva vidaha phalamaha, the result or rather the experience of that ekatva vit, that is being explained now. What is this ekatvam? Ekatvam of jivatma with paramatma, that's all. So in this sushupti, jivatma is becoming paramatma. It is not merging into paramatma, jivatma is becoming paramatma. So in fact this sushupti is being discussed here ओनली टू एक्सप्लेन और मेक अस अंडरस्टैंड दि जीव ब्रह्मैक्य जीव ब्रह्मैक्यम जीव ब्रह्मणो ऐक्यम सो दट इन ऑर्डर टू एक्सप्लेन दट दिस सुषुप्ति इज बीइंग डिस्कस्ड हियर सो ओके द नेक्स्ट मंत्र लेट अस रीड परमेवाक्षरं प्रतिपद्यते
सयोहवै
तदच्छायमशरीरमलोहितम् अच्छा देर आर फुल सुन्ना देर आर अनुस्वार देर पूर्णानुस्वार ओके तदच्छायमशरीरमलोहितम् शुभ्रमक्षरं वेदयते यस्तु सौम्य सर्वज्ञः सर्वो भवति सर्वो भवति तदेष श्लोकः ओके सो सः सर्वज्ञः सर्वो भवति द वन हू रियलाइजेस यः वेदयते द वन हू रियलाइजेस वेदयते डज नॉट मीन सीज इट इज नॉट एज दो ही इज सीइंग इट एज समथिंग डिफरेंट ही इज ओनली रियलाइजिंग जीवात्मा इज नॉट सीइंग परमात्मा जीवात्मा इज ओनली रियलाइजिंग दट ही इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम परमात्मा सो दट इज द पॉइंट स सर्व वेद यः वेदयते सः ही बिकम्स सर्वज्ञ इफ यू सी द लास्ट लाइन फर्स्ट विल सी द लास्ट लाइन फर्स्ट स सर्वज्ञ दैट पर्सन हू यः वेदयते द वन हू नोस द वन हू रियलाइजेस ही बिकम्स सर्वज्ञ ही इज अर्लियर दट वॉज दट नोइंग इन द सेंस ऑफ ड्युअलिटी something I am knowing an object earlier it was in the sense of duality but here the duality has gone we can call back our Mundakopanishad line where he says yasminnu bhagavo vijñate sarvamidam vijñatam bhavati one who knows that atma he knows everything so in that sense this word sarvajna is being used once you know that atma all other things they fall into place there is no need to know all those things they are all drushya Once you know that Atma, you realize that you know that Atman alone is real and all other things are drushya only. So that is in that sense. Sa sarvajnyaha sarvo bhavati. Sarvo bhavati means sarvaha bhavati. Sarvatma bhavam prapnoti. So he realizes oneness with everything. Sarvatma bhavam prapnoti. Tadesha shloka. In that context there is a shloka. So we will come to the first line. Paramevaksharam pratipadyate sa yohavai. The one who, sa yaha ha vai, he, ha vai is prasiddhi in order to indicate that it is very well known, very well established. The one who vedayate, shubhramaksharam vedayate yastu swamya, the one who realizes that, what happens? Param eva aksharam pratipadyate, param eva aksharam. He attains that supreme aksharam, that supreme imperishable. The supreme imperishable itself, eva shabdam also is there. Eva means itself. He attains that supreme imperishable itself, nothing short. Then, tad achayam ashariram alohitam. Achayam, shaya you know, shaya is shadow, shade, shadow rather. What is the shadow? Shadow is associated with the darkness. Darkness again is associated with ajnana. So here it is avidya ajnanam. Achayam. That is devoid of avidya. Then ashariram. Shariram is this lingopathi, linga shariram. That mind, indriyas, etc. It is referring to this linga sharira. Achayam is referring to karana sharira, avidya. Achaya, that chaya is referring to avidya. Then sharira is referring to linga sharira. Alohitam. Alohita means redness. Alohitam, it is only indicative, it is suggestive of guna, any other quality, any other attribute. Alohitam, that is lacking physical attributes. So that means achayam, ashariram, alohitam is referring to all the three shariras. In fact, that is what Anandagiri points out. Achayam, ashariram, alohitam is referring to the three shariras. It is devoid of these three shariras. Then shubhram, that is devoid of any type of visheshana, devoid of any type of attribute. When it is say something is totally clean, there is absolutely nothing on the table. That is so totally clean. That is devoid of any attributes. So that is shubhram. Aksharam that which is imperishable, what you call sat, which always exists and which doesn't disappear. That is that one. अटेन्स यह वेदयते सौम्य हे सौम्य ओ माय डियर वन यह एतत् वेदयते द वन हु रियलाइजेस दिस देन व्हाट हैपेंस टू हिम स सर्वज्ञः सर्वो भवति ही बिकम सर्वज्ञ सर्वः एटसेट्रा विल रीड द भाष्यम परमेव अक्षरम वक्ष्यमाण विशेषणं प्रतिपद्यते इत्येतदुच्यते स यो ह वै तत् सर्वैषणा विनिर्मुक्तः अच्छायं तमोवर्जितं अशरीरं नामरूप सर्वोपाधिशरीरवर्जितं अलोहितं लोहितादि सर्वगुणवर्जितं यत एव मतः शुभ्रं शुद्धं सर्वविशेषणरहितत्वात् ओके दि सेंटेंस इज फुल स्टिल नॉट कंप्लीटेड विल स्टॉप हियर परमेवाक्षरं प्रतिपद्यते ही अटेन्स दट परमेवाक्षरं दट सुप्रीम इंपेरिशबल इट्सेल्फ एंड नथिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ इट व्हाट इज दट परमेवाक्षरं वक्ष्यमाण विशेषणं हूज एट्रिब्यूट्स आर गोइंग टू बी टोल्ड इन द वेरी सेम मंत्र वक्ष्यमाण विशेषणं हूज एट्रिब्यूट्स आर गोइंग टू बी टोल्ड आर एक्सप्लेन्ड इन द सेम मंत्र इत्येतदुच्यते दट इज बीइंग टोल्ड स यो ह वै द वन हू तत् सर्वैषणा विनिर्मुक्तः सो दिस इज ए small tag which Shankaracharya is adding because unless you are the sarvaishana vinirmuktaha you cannot know unless a person is sarvaishana eshanatrayam you know eshanatrayam dareshana putreshana and lokeshana that is loka I want to achieve this loka I want to achieve swarga loka this loka etc putreshana so putreshana is again for continuing this dharma and then whatever deeds have been unfinished by this gentleman the son is supposed to continue those deeds etc that is the putreshana then vitteshana is another vitteshana attaining more and more prosperity so all these three things one has to rise above this sarveshana sarveshana vinirmuktah one who is devoid of this eshana trayam only then he can see this achhayam tamo varjitam tamas is darkness is ajnana so that achhayam that is that brahman which is devoid of this ajnana then ashariram devoid of ajnana means devoid of this duality this consciousness only associated with maya or ajnanam is becoming this jivatma isn't it so this realization the person who is realizing this he is not realizing it as mayavachinnam chaitanyam he is realizing it as pure chaitanyam that is the real nature so that is the basic substratum the basic ultimate substratum is that pure chaitanyam so achayam tamovarjitam ashariram what is ashariram nama roopa sarva upadhi sharira varjitam All the shariras are merely names and forms, nama, rupa, upadhi, and that is again upadhi. It is again a small limiting adjunct. Because there is a nama, rupa, you are because there is some sort of form, you are giving a nama and name and form. And another thing which is another upadhi, you are giving another name and form. Another upadhi, you are giving another name and form. So all these are upadhis, and this ashariram is something which is devoid of all these things. It is only reflecting in all these antahkaranas and appearing as though it is many. One is appearing as many, but in reality, this one is only one, untouched with anything, unaffected by anything, unrelated to anything. It is totally unrelational. So that is non-relational or unrelational. Then alohitam. Again, it is referring to physical attributes. Lohita. Lohita is rohita, red. Alohita. Lohita adi sarva guna varjitam. It is devoid of all attributes, physical attributes like redness, darkness, etc., etc. Then yata evam ataha, because of this, yata evam ataha, because it is like this, it is called subhram, it is nirgunam. In other words, it is called nirgunam, nirgunam brahma. Shuddham sarva visheshana rahitatvat, because it is devoid of all other attributes. Sarva visheshana rahitatvat, it is because it is devoid of all attributes, it is nirgunam, it is shuddham, shubhram. Then let us read. अक्षरम सत्यम पुरुषाख्यम अप्राणम अमनोगोचरम शिवम शांतम सबाह्याभ्यंतरम अजम वेदयते विजानाति नॉट अभ्यंतर सबाह्याभ्यंतरम सबाह्याभ्यंतरम अजम वेदयते विजानाति इवन हियर इट इज इनकम्प्लीट अक्षरम सत्यम दिस इज दट इम्पेरिशबल दट सत्यम दट सत् सत्यम कैन आल्सो रिकॉल द मीनिंग विच वी सॉ इन तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद दट विच इज त्रिकाला बाध्यम दट विच इज बियॉन्ड द थ्री कालास दट विच इज ऑलवेज दट इज दट आई सॉरी दट एग्जिस्ट घट सन पट सन दिस एग्जिस्ट 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 दट एग्जिस्टेंस इज समथिंग विच इज बियॉन्ड टाइम इट इज ऑलवेज देर सो दट इज वाई इट इज कॉल्ड सत्यम पुरुषाख्यम इट इज कॉल्ड पुरुष एंड दिस सत्यम इज समथिंग विच इज फिलिंग एवरीथिंग पुरुषाख्यम पूर्णत्वात् दट पुरुष इज ऑल्सो सत्यम देन एट द सेम टाइम इट इज अप्राणम वेन ओनली वेन इट इज हैविंग दट उपाधि इट इज सप्राणम वेन इट इज डिवॉइड ऑफ उपाधि इट इज अप्राणम ओनली वेन देर इज एन उपाधि इट इज सप्राणम वेन डिवॉइड ऑफ उपाधि इट इज अप्राणम देन अमनोगोचरम इट इज इट कैनॉट बी कैप्चर्ड बाई माइंड मनः मनोगोचरम मनोगोचरम मीन्स दट विच कैन बी कैप्चर्ड बाई द माइंड इट कैनॉट बी कैप्चर्ड बाई द माइंड शिवम दट विच इज समथिंग विच इज ऑस्पिशियस शांतम दीज आर ऑल जनरल एडजेक्टिव्स शांतम इज समथिंग वेर देर इज नो एक्टिविटी शांत दट इज वेर देर इज नो एक्टिविटी देन सबाह्याभ्यंतरम दट विच इज ऑल परवेडिंग बाह्य एंड अभ्यंतर एवरीवेर सबाह्याभ्यंतरम इज ऑल परवेडिंग अजम दट विच इज अनबॉर्न यह वेदयते यह विजानाति द वन हू रियलाइजेस दैट देन नौ यह वी आर रेफरिंग टू दट रेफ यह नौ यस्तु सर्वत्यागी सौम्य स सर्वज्ञ न तेन अविदितं किंचित् संभवति पूर्वम् अविद्यया असर्वज्ञः आसीत् पुनः विद्यया अविद्यापनये सर्वो भवति तत् तस्मिन्नर्थे एष श्लोकः मन्त्रो भवति उक्तार्थसंग्राहकः ओके यस्तु सर्वत्यागी द वन दिस सर्वत्यागी अगेन एज वी सी एज वी सॉ इट इज समथिंग विच इज अ टैग एडेड बाय शंकराचार्य यस्तु सर्वत्यागी द वन हू इज अ रिनाउंसर ऑफ ऑल एंड इन फैक्ट इन सुषुप्ति ही हैज रिनाउंस्ड ऑल In fact, from Sushupti we are taking a lesson. From Sushupti we have taken a lesson that just as in Sushupti a man totally gives up everything, he loosens his grip, either on his wife or on the bundle of notes, whatever it is, he loosens his grip and then he is totally becomes a sarvatyagi. In the same manner, in wakefulness, in jagradavastha, a person can cultivate. And then he becomes like in Sushupti, a person is amanaha. Amanaha, that is where there is no mind. In Jagrat also he can become amanaha, where he can become that manas can be withdrawn. Manas can totally become withdrawn. So that is what is the lesson which we are drawing from this Sushupti. Yes, to Sarvatyagi, because this Sarvatyaga renunciation is a prerequisite. Sarvatyagi, he somya, sa sarvajnaha. In that deep sleep, we are seeing this person as sarvajna. Natena aviditam kinchit sambhavati. Because, in fact, this tyaga takes place automatically. In sushupti, tyaga takes place automatically. And in consciousness or in the waking state, this man has to develop over a period of time. He has to do this ravana manana nididhyasana. And much prior to that, he has to do this sadhana chatushtaya sampatti. Only after sadhana chatushtaya sampatti he comes to this level of shravana manana nididhyasana. So sa sarvajnya natena aviditam kinchit sambhavati, because once he knows this atman there is nothing else to be known. All other things they fall in place, all other things are not known to him. Then purvam avidyaya asarvajnya asit, because of avidya he was asarvajnya. Asarvajnya means he was knowing this but not knowing that. He was knowing something else, he was not knowing something else. Now, once having known the Atman, he has become Sarvajna. In the sense, he has started realizing that all others are drushyam. All others are mere drushyam. And there is nothing much about them. Then, punaha avidyaya vidya apanaye. Vidyaya avidyapanaye sati. Vidyaya, by this vidya, by proper education or by proper realization, avidya avidyayaha apanayaha sanjataha. Avidya avidyapanaye sati. Once that avidya has been removed, after that removal of avidya, sarvo bhavati, he attains that sarvatma bhava. Sarvatma bhava. Like in Sushupti, a king and a beggar are equal. So there is a sarvatma bhava there. So similarly, in the waking state, this man has to attain sarvatma bhava. There is a realized person attains sarvatma bhava. In Sushupti, automatically it takes place. Both are equal. So similarly, in the waking state again, he becomes a sarvatma bhava. He attains that sarvatma bhava. And in that sense, tasminarthe, yesha shlokaha, there is a mantra in this particular context. Uktartha sangrahakaha means sangrahakaha, sangrahena vadati. Sangrahena yesha shlokaha vadati. That is capturing the essence of what has been told earlier. Uktartha sangrahakaha. Sangrahakam means that which is capturing the essence of what has been told earlier. Then let us see the next mantra. Vijnanatma sahadeva ischa sarvaihi. Prana bhutani sampratishthanti yatra. Tadaksharam vedayate yastu somya. Sa sarvajna sarvameva visheseti. Visheseti. Not vishesha, sarvameva avishesha. Sarvameva visheseti. Okay. Itya Sarva Veda Upanishad, Itya Sarva Vediya Prashna Upanishad, Chaturtha Prashnaha. Okay. So now again, it is a concluding sentence. So we have seen this nature of Shuddha Chaitanya as Asanga. It is totally non-relational, unattached to anything. And then this Vijnanatma, the one who realizes this Vijnanatma or the real nature of Vijnanatma as pure consciousness, so he becomes a Sarvajna. That is the overall meaning of this. Vijnanatma saha veda devaischa sarvaihi. This jivatma, Vijnanatma is referring to jivatma, kshetrajna. Then saha devaischa. Deva means all these indriyas, manas, etc. You know, deva refers to not only deities, it is referring to these indriyas. Divyate, from that diva, from that root diva, that which is associated with intelligence because consciousness is reflecting on them. Saha devaischa sarvaihi. Then pranaha bhutanicha. Pranaha, we have seen this pancha pranaha. Bhutanicha, prithivyadi bhutanicha. Then sampratishthanti yatra. Where all these things get resolved. So tadaksharam vivedayate yastu somya. Yaha tadaksharam vedayate. Tadaksharam. Tad means it is referring to yatra. Yatra all these sampratishthanti. Where all these things they merge. The one who knows that. That is the connection. Tad aksharam yaha vedayate, he somya, o dear one, yaha vedayate, sa sarvajna, he is sarvajna, he is the knower of all. In fact, it is almost a repetition of the earlier mantra, sa sarvajna sarvo bhavati, sa sarvajna, sarvameva avivesha, that is, he enters all, sarvameva avivesha, vishadhatu. Avivesha, pravivesha, Pravishat, so that is it. Sarvameva avivesha. That is, he has attained that sarvatma bhavam. He has entered all. So that is the meaning of general meaning. Let us see the bhashyam. Vijnanatma sahadevaischa agnyadibhihi pranaha chakshuradayaha bhutani prithivyadini Sampratishthanti pravishanti yatra yasmin akshare tad aksharam vedayate yastu somya priyadarshana स सर्वज्ञः सर्वमेव आविवेश आविशति इत्यर्थः ओके सो विज्ञानात्मा एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर विज्ञानात्मा अलांग विद दि सह देवैश्च अलांग विद ऑल दिस ऑर्गन्स अलांग विद दिस उपाधीस ऑल दिस उपाधीस चक्षुरादयः एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा संप्रतिष्ठन्ति अगेन वी हैव टू रिकॉल व्हाट आनंदगिरी पॉइंटेड आउट दैट वी कांट स्ट्रिक्टली स्पीकिंग वी कांट से जीवात्मा इज गेटिंग रिजॉल्व्ड जीवात्मा इज ऑलवेज देयर इट इज द उपाधीस विच आर गेटिंग रिजॉल्व्ड दट उपाधि स्वरूप ओनली उपहित रूपाभाव एव अस्य लयः दैट्स व्हाट ही सेड दट उपहित रूपाभाव दट जीवात्म भाव विल डिसअपियर एंड देन ही विल रिमेन एज परमात्मा जीवात्म भाव दट जीवात्म उपहित रूपम दट दट इज दट इज दिस दिस डीलिमिटेड पर्सनैलिटी डिसअपियर्स द डीलिमिटेड पर्सनैलिटी डिसअपियर्स एंड दट जीवात्म रिमेन्स एज परमात्मा सो विज्ञानात्मा सह देवैश्च व्हाट आर दिस देवाः अग्नियादिभिः अग्नि एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा आर द देवास इट आल्सो रेफर्स टू इंद्रियास अग्नि रेफर्स टू आई सो लाइक दट इंद्रियास देन प्राणः चक्षुरा प्राणाः चक्षुरादयः ओके हियर ऑफ कोर्स प्राणाः ओके शंकराचार्य हैज गिवन अ डिफरेंट मीनिंग देवैश्च अग्नियादिभिः प्राणाः चक्षुरादयः इन अ सेंस प्राणाग्नयः सो दैट इन दैट सेंस नो प्राणाग्नयः इज डिफरेंट प्राणाग्नयः एव अत्र जागर्ति वेयर दट रेफरेंस टू प्राणाग्नयः इज रेफरिंग टू प्राण अपान एटसेट्रा वी आर नॉट रेफरिंग टू प्राणाग्नयः हियर प्राणः इज चक्षुरादयः प्योरली इंद्रियाणि देन भूतानि पृथिव्यादीनि दिस पंचभूताः दिस सा ग्रास फाइव एलिमेंट्स देन संप्रतिष्ठन्ति प्रविशन्ति ऑल दीज थिंग्स दे मर्ज इंटू वाट यत्र यस्मिन् अक्षरे प्रविशन्ति वेयर ऑल दीज थिंग्स गेट रिजॉल्वड देन तदक्षरं यः वेदयते दट अक्षरं That imperishable, all these things as though entering the huge sea. All these things, they enter the huge sea and merge there. So like that, Tad aksharam vedayate yastu somya. Hey somya, oh dear one, yaha vedayate. Then saha, that person, sarvajnyaha, he becomes the sarvajnya, the knower of all. Sarvameva avivesha. Avivesha means avishati. Avivesha is the past tense. Avishati is... You have to take it in the present tense. A person who knows this, he enters all. That means he becomes one with all. Enters all means he becomes one with all. He realizes that he is not different from, say, any other being. So that sarvatma bhava is automatically there for a realized person. So ultimately one great lesson which we see in this the whole thing is, this seeing of oneness, that is the basic thing. That is one who realizes his real nature as Brahman. He attains the Sarvatma Bhava. That is, he sees oneness in all. That means he loves all unconditionally, like he loves himself. That is a corollary which follows. That he loves all, he respects all, he has concern for all. All these things is a corollary for this thing. So sarvameva avivesha. That is, he attains Sarvatma Bhava. सो इति श्रीमशंकर भगवत् श्रीमत् परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा कृतौ प्रश्नोपनिषद् भाष्ये चतुर्थ प्रश्नः दिस इज द फोर्थ प्रश्न सो इन दिस मंत्र इन दिस फोर्थ प्रश्न वी हैव सीन द नेचर ऑफ आत्मा एज सेल्फ लुमिनस दैट इज नंबर वन एंड देन इन द एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ दिस सुषुप्ति वी हैव सीन दट दिस नेचर ऑफ दिस द आत्मा इज रियली असंग समथिंग विच इज non-relational, unconnected with anything. It is only when connected with these upadhis, it becomes the drashta, shrota, etc., etc. But in reality, this atma is something which is asanga. So these are the things which we saw in the fourth mantra. And also one more point which we saw is that atma is something ananda swarupa, where that attainment of bliss is there. And where this experience of duality is totally absent. So we will come to the fifth question. Fifth question is rather simpler when compared to the fourth question because fifth question is about Omkara Upasana. So up to the fourth question, up to question number three, it related to prana. In fourth, there is a slightly delicate discussion regarding to epistemology, epistemology is, what exactly is the nature of Atma, etc. That sort of thing, there was a discussion. But here, it is again coming to Omkara Upasana. That is, when we say Uttamadhikari, Mandadhikari, etc., the earlier question was for a Uttamadhikari, directly analysis of, a direct analysis of Avasthatraya. It was told to that person. But here, for somebody who is not so well qualified, not so well equipped intellectually, for him, Mandadhikari, this is being explained. Anandagiri gives a small introduction. Evam Chaturtha Prashnena Mandama Uttamadhikarinaha. Chaturtha Prashna is for Uttamadhikari. And what happened there? Padartha Shodhana Purvakam. This Vampadartha Shodhanam has taken place. That Tvam and Tatpadartha Shodhanam. That is an analysis of what is Tvam and Tat. What is this Jivatma and Paramatma? That analysis was made in that Chaturtha Prashna. Now we are coming to Atra Anadhikarinaha. Manda-vairagyavataha, omityevam dhyayata atmanam, etc., etc. For a mandadhikari, for somebody who is a second level student, not the first top level student, but a second level student, for him, this upasana, etc. is being told. So that is what is the avatarika by Anandagiri. Let us see the mantra. Atha hainam shaibhya satya kamah paprakshya.
Atha hainam shaibhya satya kamah.
सयोहवै
तद्भगवन्
मनुष्येषु प्रायणान्तमोङ्कारमभिध्यायीत कथमं वाव स तेन लोकं जयतीति तस्मै स होवाच. ओके, अथ इज देयर आफ्टर. अथ ha is, as we all know, as is well known, ha, or rather it seems, enam means referring to Pippalada, enam gurum, enam Pippaladam, shaibhyaha satyakamaha paparaksha. This shaibhyaha is son of Sibi, his name is Satyakama. Paparaksha, he asked, what? Sa yohavai, the one who, indeed, who knows what, tad bhagavan, manushyeshu prayanantam omkaram abhidhyayita. Rayanantam means Maranantam, till his death, that means all through his life. Rayanantam is Maranantam, that is all through his life. The one who, Manushyeshu among people, the one who does this Omkara Upasana all through his life, Abhidhyayita means very in a dedicated way, Abhidhyayita, Abhidhyanam, Abhi referring to, it is supportive of the main word, Abhidhyanam. That is, very dedicatedly he is doing dhyanam. So, for such a person, katamam lokam jayati. Katamam lokam tena jayati. Tena means, not by that person, by that abhidhyanam, by that meditation. Tena is not referring to the person here. Tena dhyanena. That is, by such dhyanam, katamam lokam jayati. What type of loka does he attain? Does he attain some swargaloka? Does he attain some other inferior loka, or does he attain some higher loka? So we are now referring to what is called Krama Mukti and Sadhya Mukti. We have seen in Gita Bhashyam also, there are two levels of achievement. That is, one is the Sadhya Mukti. That is, for a top level student who has attained this Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti initially, and from Sadhana Chatushtaya he goes to Savra Shravana Manana Nididhyanam. What happens to him? He through all this analysis of Atma, Anatma, etc., he realizes his self as the Supreme Self. So that is the moksha, that is the top thing, that is what is called Sadhyo Mukti or Jivan Mukti. While he is alive, he is liberated. But for a person who is not able to do that, there are some other things told. For a very, very ordinary man, okay, you do this puja, you do this so-and-so upasana. For a slightly higher level man, Omkara Upasana is told. For a very, very ordinary man, okay, who is at the level of religion, a person who is at the level of ordinary Vigraha, Vigrahara, Vigraha Puja, etc., okay, you take this idol and then worship it. So that some discipline is there in your life, and then it will give you some sort of buddhi at some point of time. You will slowly attain this Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti, and then slowly come to the higher level, etc., for the lowest person. For a slightly in the middle level person, Omkara Dhyanam is told. So that is what is mentioned here. So this Krama Mukti, yeah, I was referring to Krama Mukti. So this Omkara Dhyanam, where does it lead? It leads to Brahmaloka Prapti. We have seen in Gita Bhashyam, Brahmaloka is Hiranyagarbhaloka. That also is one level of Sarvatma Bhava only. That is again one level of Sarvatma Bhava, not the highest level of Sarvatma Bhava. In that Sarvatma Bhava also there are two levels. So this Virat Purusha, Virat Upasana, what we have seen, this Prana Upasana, also is leading to Sarvatma Bhava. He is seeing oneness with the whole universe. The first discovery is that his grass body, his body, whatever is the grass body, or rather the microcosm, is not different from the grass body at the cosmic level. That is the Virat Sharira. Yes, his body is not different from that, say, macrocosm. His stola sharira is not, his limited stola sharira, vyashti stola sharira is not different from that samashti. This vyashti or microcosm is not different from that samashti or macrocosm. So that is the first discovery, even at the prana level. And now, at a higher level, he is realizing that whatever, what is this chaitanya which is reflecting in this body-mind complex, is not other than that Shuddha Chaitanya. It is the same as Shuddha Chaitanya, that is the higher level. So this is at a slightly lower level, that is, he is realizing that he is at one level, he is realizing that Sarvatma Bhava, and then he is reaching that Brahmaloka, where at the end of that tenure of Brahma, he attains Mukti. Because this Brahma also, there is a tenure, isn't it? According to our Puranas, according to our scriptures, this Brahma is again a manifestation. That Brahma's manifestation is there in that cycle of creation. After that cycle of creation is over, along with that Brahma, he attains Mukti. So that is accepted even in Vedanta. Okay. So let us see the Bhashyam. Atha idanim parapara Brahma prapti sadhanatvena. ओंकारस्य उपासना विधित्सया प्रश्नः आरभ्यते. सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज बिगन. प्रश्नः आरभ्यते, इट इज बीइंग बिगन. व्हाट फॉर इदानीम अथ देयर आफ्टर. देयर आफ्टर मींस आफ्टर वी हैव सीन द टॉप लेवल स्टूडेंट नोइंग समथिंग. वी आर नॉट इन द टॉप लेवल, वी आर इन अ स्लाइटली लोअर लेवल. सो इदानीम परापर ब्रह्म प्राप्ति साधनत्वेन. This Brahma Prapti Sadhanam, no doubt. This Omkara is Brahma Prapti Sadhanam. And it is, it can attain both Parabrahma and Aparabrahma. Para and Apara. Parabrahma is that supreme reality, that what we call Shuddha Chaitanya. Aparabrahma is that conditioned Brahman. Conditioned Brahman is that Saguna Brahma. Saguna Brahma, what we call Hiranyagarbha Brahma. And in that Hiranyagarbha Brahma only, we visualize various God forms and then we worship. So at that level, para para brahma prapti sadhanatvena. And this Omkara is para brahma prapti, it helps para brahma prapti and also para brahma prapti. That is, first of all you attain this apara brahma and through that you attain the para brahma. So it is called the krama mukti in a phased manner, a phased liberation. Omkarasya upasana vidhitsaya. Vidhitsa is desire to prescribe. Vidhanam. Vidhi is an injunction, isn't it? Vidhanam is a sort of order, a sort of not exactly imposition. It is an injunction, let us say. Vidhitsaya, desire to prescribe. Vidhanam is prescription, let us say. Then vidhitsaya, in order to prescribe this Omkara as a means for attaining both Parabrahma and Aparabrahma, that is both the Shuddha Brahma, that is absolute Brahman, and also the empirical Brahman, this prashna is being begun. So I think we can continue in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.